Footscray lead by 6 points going into the final term here at the Sydney Cricket Ground. Knocked down by Berry. Burton's kick only travels a couple of metres. And I think we'll see another ball up just adjacent to the circle, which is hardly visible. Quite deep mud out there in the centre. Although the rest of the ground seems quite okay. Round and Berry knocked away by Round. Oh, Burton slips, couldn't get off the mark quick enough. Out to Davidson. Stan Davidson making pretty good ground to get there. Right, hot on his hammer. Back to Burton, the ruck rover. Burton's kick is short. Across to half-back. Hounsell late on the scene and taking it away for Footscray out towards Ted Whitten. Whitten goes for the short one. Templeton. Rickman. Oh, well smothered. Picked up again by Rickman, or in fact almost. Oh, Reed was legged. Has to get a free kick. He would be 50 metres out from goal.
Tell you what, Peter, goal here will make it pretty nasty for the Swans.
It will make it interesting, Lou, that's for certain. Bruce Reed, 50 metres out from goal. Torpedo punt kick. Beautiful kick for goal, like Michael Tuck's yesterday. Full points. The Bulldogs lead by 12 points.
Oh, Bobby, that could be the killer. It's a long way to go, but that's the sort of goal that inspires a team, isn't it?
Yes, it's lovely to get that first goal after a break. And we see now as Bruce Reed puts the ball forward and right through the centre, just over the line, but the goal umpire in perfect position to decide whether or not that was touched.
2 goals, the difference at the SCG, 91 to 79.
And that goal coming within 2 minutes of the start of the last quarter. Knocked out by Berry again. Not a good one. It finally comes down to Shane Morwood now on the ground. Little Davidson falls on top of it. And finally it's pushed out again to Paul Morwood. I think he was grabbed by the foot. And he'll get a free kick out there on the centre wing position. The Swans trailing by 12 points. And they're really in the hot seat at the moment. They've got to win this game to keep their final five chances alive. A long kick over the centre half forward position. Punched away by Berry again. Wright fumbles the ball. Finally, it's out there again to Evans. A snapshot for goal. A chance now for the big fella Talbot to mark, but the umpire said it'll be a free kick down the field.
No, back.
It's going back, is it, to Evans? He's claiming it should go down the field, but the umpire won't have a bar of that. He's got to take his kick from where the incident happened.
Umpire Kevin Smith perfectly correct, I think, Bob, because he wasn't tackled after he got rid of the ball.
Exactly right, Pete.
We wait now for Evans from about 25 or 20 metres out from goal, if that, to kick goal number one and make the difference 6 points. Vital kick by Bernie Evans. And he's made a point of it. That's a bad miss that time. So it's 11 points the difference. We see the Swans 10 goals, 20-80 to Footscray 14-7-91. 6 straight points Evans has kicked without scoring a goal, Peter.
11 points the difference. In front is to Conning. Out it comes to Morwood. That's Shane Morwood, I think, on the ground for the first time in the match. To fall forward. Oten, a good mark. Oten has kicked 4 goals. His conversion rate has certainly been better than Bernie Evans. I think he's kicked 4-1. Michael Oten directly in front of goal. Taking his conversion rate as a yardstick. He could get that one, or should. Hit the post, did it? Yes, it did, said the goal umpire. No luck for the Swans at the moment. So they kicked 3-9 in the third quarter and they've added 2 behind so far in the final term to make the difference 10 points. Well, luck going with the Bulldogs.
That could be 2 fatal misses, those, Peter.
Well, they're certainly attacking enough. They'll get the opportunities, they might still be right. Reed takes the grab in front of Browning. He's played fairly well. To centre wing. Round is there, or spilt the mark, spoilt by his own teammate, Rickman. Round again, back to Paul Morwood, and well tackled by Rickman. Plenty of weight being used in the packs, and the umpire, Peter Howe, has decided on a ball up.
Ball up on the centre wing position. Knocked out by Berry again, doing a great job in the ruck. Finally, Burton comes out, it's smothered back to David Rees-Jones. A hand pass out now wide, and finally there's a short pass by Little Hounsell. Browning's got it now, had a bit of trouble getting that clear. A hand pass coming over to Paul Morwood. A bit of juggling going on. Well tackled that time by Gordy. Towns grabbed, back it goes to the wide open space as Big Berry overruns the ball. Finally, it's Little Hounsell. Plenty of pressure on the Swans at the moment as they're trying to win this match as it goes down towards their half-forward line. Finally knocked out to Rickman, a very strong player. Goes for a pass, intercepted that time by Bernie Evans. Backs up well, a hand pass coming over to Big Max Cruz. Another one to Neesham at centre half-forward. A pass and a good mark there to Tony Moore, who had a great third quarter. And Tony Moore was kicked one goal up to this stage of the match.
See it again on replay now. Moore. That's how you take marks.
Well, if he kicks this goal, it'll be, 4 points the difference. There's the kick by Morwood. But once again, they're off target. And are through for another point. So they're giving away plenty of chances, the Swans, at the moment. 82 points, the Swans to Footscray, 91. 9 points the difference.
32 scoring shots to 21.
Well, it's not the amount of scoring shots, is where you place the ball that counts, Robert. And of course, we're waiting now for the fullback to bring the ball back into play. Out there towards that half back line. Reed at the back, a great strong mark. He's been a pretty fair player today for Footscray, and they've had many good players. He goes for the long kick, trying to get the ball up there to Templeton. Punched away, he's got a free kick, Templeton, and ready to send them deep into attack down there to Beasley.
Kelvin Templeton, just about on the centre wing position. He's a long way from goal. Short pass. Christensen. No, not Christensen. McPherson can't take the mark. The whistle has gone. It will be a free kick going to the Swans' Jared Neesham in the back pocket, who goes across goal. Could be dangerous, but Ackerley's on his own. There's not a Bulldog player within 30 metres. Short pass. Browning from right half-back flank. Beautiful kick. Over the top, Tony Morwood. Brian Cordy at the back. Awkward-looking punt kick to centre wing position. Rhys Jones is there, and he sees the ball bounce over the line. 10 points the difference at the SCG. In fact, make it 9, 82 to 91. Berry and Shane Morwood. Berry has the height. Knock-on favours the Swans. Paul Morwood is there. Back it comes to Davidson. Hand pass. Bulldogs get out of trouble, only to see Neesham in the road at centre wing. Back to Browning. Browning from McPherson. Long kick by Browning. Could almost be a score. Behind again. So another one they've added, let me see. Four behinds this quarter, Bob Skilton. 10-23.
Yes, not a goal. 3 points.
10-23 to 14-7. 83 to 91. Carroll sets himself. Well, who's got that? Have to leave that to the umpire. It's going Footscray's way, and the mark is being paid out there to Comp.
Good strong mark by Comp out there at halfback. Kick falls a bit short, and they're still finally going back into attack again through McPherson. There's a chance now for Reed to get it, but he loses it. McKenna's got it. He's grabbed but still gets a hand pass. We see Big Cruz go for the defensive tactics and finally forces the ball out of bounds, but it's on Footscray's half forward line now, about 55 metres around from their goal. Difference only 8 points, but the Swans finding it very difficult to pick up that margin. Crowd ironically cheering the umpire as we see Round get a free kick down there at half back. An awkward looking kick. It's not a very good one, and we see a good mark taken there by Rickman. He's a strong sort of a player, this guy too, Bob.
He's done quite a good job since he came on, Lou.
So Rickman with the ball. Now he's got a chance to send the Bulldogs back into attack again. Over there half four. That's a good pass. And there's a mark taken there, this time by Rod McPherson. Ball kicked across towards the centre half forward position, the pack fly. Two South Melbourne for Swan players fighting trip, but the umpire has paid the mark there to Morwood. Played very well since half time. Out to Browning. Browning balked. Was going to give it to Paul Morwood. Decides to get it up there towards Oaten. Punched away that time by Comp. Then he lost it. Back it goes to Wigan. Now Oaten's got it again. He goes down. Nearly a free kick to Oaten for what's against him. I thought it could have been a push in the back.
Yes, he had an opportunity to get a hand pass in.
So the free kick going there to Footscray, finally picked up by Brian Cordy out to his brother. Well intercepted by David Rhys-Jones. Neesham kicks it out to him again. Another long hand pass down there to Stephen Wright on the boundary line. Hooks the ball back, looking for Fashini. Punched away by Egan. They're not giving them much chance at all at the moment, the Bulldog defence. They're really going in for this ball, and the umpire's going to ball it up down there towards the forward pocket position for the Swans.
Well, the Bulldogs hanging in there. The Swans have had most of the attacking in this final term. Knocked out to Stephen Wright. Rhys Jones is there after Wright does the shepherding. In the forward pocket, the mark spilt. It'll be rushed through, will it? No, it's still in play, I think. Behind. It goes through. So the difference now as the Swans sneak closer. 10-24-84. A deficit of 7 points only to 14-7-91. They'll win it by kicking behinds, I think. Mark taken out there by McPherson. And a 15-metre penalty against Tony Morwood. Brings Rod McPherson up towards right half-back flank. Not the greatest of passes of the afternoon. Berry in all sorts of trouble. Evans intercepting. Brian Cordy in for the assist for the Bulldogs. He can't make any headway either.
You often find when a side's kicked as many points as the Swans at the moment, the other crowd get it down there and score a goal immediately, don't they, Bob?
It's amazing how often it happens.
Brian Cordy gets it back to the mud patch in the centre. Browning would certainly pay that mark. And Mark Browning would just about be able to put this in the 10-metre square if he goes for a long kick. If he can gain footing there, that might be the problem. As you can see, it's fairly muddy. Plenty of Footscray players are there, and the mark is brought in by Big Berry. To Burton, in trouble, but gets out of it well. A more than useful twist. Into the centre, looking for Edmund. Mark at the back to Templeton. Over towards McKenna. Plenty of Swans players down there. Ackley put Rod McPherson out of business. Still a chance for the Bulldogs. Whitten caught when not in possession. Paul Morwood to Hounsell. Hounsell from the back pocket in towards centre field. Long kick. Shane Morwood overruns the ball. McPherson again. Wright has it, but it will be a ball up, says umpire Kevin Smith at centre field. Oh, very, very tight tackling. Neither side able to break clear at the moment. Still the Swans doing most of, making most of the forward moves. Shane Morwood could be able to make another one here if he gets it to Reece Jones. He can. Reece Jones in trouble. Well tackled. Rickman again in the mud bath. He didn't have the ball, and it will be a free kick to Rickman just short of centre field.
Just over the 12-minute mark, and the Bulldogs still in front by 7 points as we see the ball driven up there by Rickman. Edmund couldn't hold that mark. It hits the deck again. There's a chance for Hounsell to get clear. Strikes his opponent off McPherson that time. Goes for a pass. It's OK, and it's found Neesman at centre field. A hand pass over to Tony Morwood. A long one back to his brother Paul. Back to the brother. Took about brotherly love. They messed that up now as Brian Cordy pounces on the ball. Tries to get clear. A hand pass coming out there to Steve McPherson. Out to the temple to bounce the wrong way. Knocked back by Cruz to Neesham. Let's hope he can do better this time as he drives the ball out wide to Paul Morwood. Hit him on the leg. This gives Steve McPherson a chance to break clear. Now the Bulldogs will go back into attack. It's a pass. A bit short, but it bounced okay for McKenna. Back to Neil Cordy again. A kick high and a chance now for the big fella to mark the ball. Beasley couldn't hold that. Tapped away by Browning. Over to Round. In a bit of trouble. Back to Round again. Round goes out wide instead of going directly down the ground. There's a great battle between Whitten and Hounsell at the moment as the ball comes out to the centre wing position. Hounsell's got it under control, but can he break clear? He's attacked that time by Egan. Finally over to Burton. They won't give up, these Bulldogs. Talk about determined. Well picked up by Reed. A long hand pass. A chance now for Whitten. Another hand pass coming over. And McKenna's grabbed, but he's clear. He might get one in the back. He's got it too high. Get a free kick. And as we were saying before, they've only hit the ball up their end about twice this quarter. He could even score a goal, but he's a bit of a distance out at the moment.
A bad tackle though by Cardaloo.
Got him too high, no doubt about that. The umpire was right on the spot. So we see McKenna at centre-half forward about 45 to 50 metres out from goal. And they're leading by 7 points at the moment. Should land this well in the goal square. There's the kick by McKenna into the goal square. Big Templeton gets up. Couldn't hold the mark. It's finally forced out of Ackley.
It goes wide to the pocket. Good run to Reece Jones. Ackley will get it back from that player. Not Reece Jones' best handball for the day. Ackley's kick sees McAllister getting underneath the ball for a safe mark at centre wing. A pass to McKenna. Backing up at the back was Berry. McKenna plays on. Needs a big mark down in the forward pocket. Brian Cordy, Neil Cordy, correction. Reece Jones giving him, making him earn it. Let's put it that way.
Well, he's had the better of David Reece Jones today, Bob.
Yes, he's played well, then.
Reece Jones has done some useful things, though. Neil Cordy, left half forward flank, about 55 metres out from goal at least. He's going to play for the drop punt, so he'll lose distance. He may gain accuracy. Into the goal square. No one waiting down. Carroll will be content to see it over the line, and it will be a boundary throw in Footscray's right forward pocket. They haven't had too many chances this turn. The Swans have had the ball up their end most of the time, knocked away by Round to Tony Morwood to Browning. Browning clear of Burton. Up to the centre. Berry. Right. Helgren not in possession. He'll get a free kick. You get a 15-metre penalty if he doesn't give it back. Stephen Wright, short of centre field. Oh, that was bad luck. Footscray player fell over. Bashini takes advantage of it. He will surely go from here. 10 metres out. Bangs through. The Swans come back pretty hard.
Tonight.
1 point the difference at the SCG, 91-90.
And we're at the 16-minute mark of this last quarter. And the pressure really on now as the ball is finally driven up there by McKenna. Bouncing over the head of Carroll, knocked out by Browning, picked up by Reed. Back to Carroll again at centre-half, back in a bit of bother, but finally gets a kick up to centre-half forward. Allender on the ground, couldn't hold that mark. Back to Tony Morwood. Out it goes to Neesham, a fumble. And there's a chance now for Evans to get a wild hand pass. But backing up well is Reed, one over the head. And a chance now for Footscray to get the ball clear. Out towards Rickman on that centre wing position. Another hand pass to Edmund. And they go back into attack. They won't give in this Bulldog mob. It's a point the difference. Back to Ackley. And look at him go now. Oh, down goes one Footscray player. And finally a hand pass from Ackley over to Neesham. Out wide, it'll be a mark. And a mark there to open. He'd be about 45 to 50 metres out from goal, and Oaten's already kicked four. Talk about a pro-Swans crowd here up in Sydney at the moment. There wouldn't be four people barring for Footscray at the moment at the Sydney Cricket Ground as we wait now for Oaten to fire at the goals. It's a good kick, but doesn't quite make the distance. And Berry comes on the scene, and it's finally forced out of bounds right against the point post. So it's still a point the difference in favour of the Bulldogs. And they've led at the end of every quarter. Can they do it again and spoil the Swans' chance of making the final four, whatever chance they've got? Bit of a scrimmage as Berry gets it out, doing a great job. Over there to McKenna, and McKenna drives it wide, looking there for Cordy. Cordy flies, couldn't hold the mark. Reed goes in, chipping in as Edmund, showing a lot of strength, and he'll go for the kick now. Oh, he's balked, he's in a bit of trouble. Now he's clear, goes for a pass. And it's a mark there to Stephen Rod McPherson.
15 metres.
It goes for a short pass again. It'll be another mark. And we see a chance here for his brother, Steve McPherson, to a goal. And the Bulldogs have got another goal. 7 points the difference now. 15-7-97 Footscray to the Swans. 11 goals, 24-90.
A strong play by Edmund there. He took the gamble, came right around, and was prepared to take a bit of a risk as we once again see McPherson coming in, running his full 15 metres and making no mistake.
Footscray have kicked two goals this quarter. The Swans have kicked one goal, five. Tony Franklin and Ricky Quaid looking on. 97-90 in favour of Footscray. Round to Neesham. Picked up by Reed, in fact, almost. The Swans go into attack through Paul Morwood on his own. Allender at half forward will be able to score from there with any sort of a kick.
Great game at the moment, Peter, isn't it?
Fantastic game.
Well, it's been a great game all day. It's been very close.
And this will make the difference 1 point again if Stephen Allender can boot it from there. There shouldn't be too many problems. He's only 20 metres out, or 25 at the very most. I think he's missed it. Goodness me. So another behind. That means the Swans this quarter have kicked, let me see, one goal, six. Footscray have added two straight goals. So the difference is the same as it was at three-quarter time, and that is 6 points.
So it's four goals, 15 since half-time.
That's unbelievable, isn't it, Bob?
It has just been bad kicking, hasn't it?
Yep.
Kicks like that, there's no pressure on there.
Council, that's a good kick. For a goal, or is it touched? Touched, one behind. No umpire in pretty good position to see that. Bad luck for Hounsall. It just didn't carry. Let's watch it again in replay, and you'll see the goal umpire in pretty good position to see that. He was right on the line and touched through for one behind. So the score is 92-97. 5 points the difference, although the scoreboard says 91. I think we're correct in 92. Mark for Barry Round over Berry. Get our statistician to score to check that, because it is pretty important. We make it 5 points the difference. Up to full forward for the Swans. Two players spoiled each other there. Neesham flicks it out to Tony Moore. Well tackled by McKenna. Berry and Round. Round at the back. Free kick to...
Played a great game, Berry.
Yes, he has. He's done well. Bill Berry from right half-back flank. In towards centre field. Oh, Carroll, good grab. That was a splendid mark. Dennis Carroll in replay. Fine mark. Carroll to half-forward. Some jostling. Mark to Berry again. Oh, what a finish we've got to this match. Can Footscray hang on? Can the Swans keep their finals hopes alive? Here's Carroll again for another mark. It's a push-out, though. Free kick to the Swans. It will be taken by Maxie Cruz at half-back.
And we're about just over the 20-minute mark. 5 points the difference in favour of the Bulldogs. Down there towards Tony Morwood. He couldn't hold the mark. It's knocked out to David Rees-Jones. There's a chance it will go further forward. Now's it marked to Allender. And he's got the mark about 40 metres out from goal. He was pressed heavily to the ground. And there's a 15-metre penalty.
Couldn't miss this one,
could he? Well, this has given him a chance. If he kicks this goal, it'll be a point in favour of the Swans. And what a game. Louis Hampshire on his feet. Well, it's got everyone on their feet here at the moment. A great game put up by these both sides. But full marks to the Bulldogs. They've really put in an effort today. Allender, he knows the importance of this kick. And I would say he's no world certainty to kick it either. Let's see what he can do with this one. He's fired. That's okay. It's a goal.
Somewhere below freeze.
Bias.
No, it's against him for holding the ball.
Yeah, well, that was foolish play because he had the chance to really sew it up for the Swans that time, Bob.
Yes, I cannot understand a player even thinking of doing that at that stage.
Well, if they lose the game, he better go in the Footscray dressing room because I think the coach will have a bit of him now. We see Barry Round take the mark and he should go for the long kick to get it down there as quickly as he possibly can. Goes for a short pass. I'm getting excited as we see Reed take the mark at half forward. His kick is over there towards the full forward zone. And finally off, flying high. There is the Fashini again. That was a Fashini.
Tony Morwood.
There's two of them having a grab there. And it's Tony Morwood to take that mark. Only about, 30 metres out from goal directly in front. And Tony Morwood's already kicked one goal. And Bobby's played a very good game since half-time.
Yes, his second half has been a big improvement on his first because it most certainly was needed as well.
Yeah, I'd say. Well, a chance to put them 7 points in front now. There's the kick. And there's no doubt about that. It's through for 4 points. So, we see the score. The Swans are now 13 goals, 26, 104. The Footscray 15, 7, 97.
Well, the inevitable, I think, happening, Bob. The Swans have had most of the play this quarter, and they're finally getting goals.
Well, they have had most of the play this half, but bad kicking is bad football, and to Footscray's credit, they've hung in there all the way.
7 points the difference, 104 to 97. Berry to Rickman. Cruz and Templeton. Templeton taps it to Reed. Reed up the half forward. Fashini and Egan. De Conning. Out to Davidson. Short pass. Footscray get out of the danger zone through Burton. Back towards half forward. They need a goal quickly. Umpire Peter Howe has elected to ball it up as we enter the time on period now of the final term. Evans. Back to the point of the square. Good mark taken down there by Egan. Fashini being whistled back on the mark. Reed at the back, too tall for Browning. No mark to either player. Hounsell roves it well. Gets around a couple of opponents. Long kick to half forward. Looking for Allender. Fashini could sew it up. Bounce. Hit the post. So that means the Bulldogs need 2 goals. To win the match. I don't think they can do it. 105 to 97. That's 8 points. 2 goals will have to be kicked by Footscray in the time on period to win the match. Berry and Round to Morwood. Touched off the boot. It will be play on. Neesham tries to. Loses the ball. McAllister back to centre field. Fine mark to Rees-Jones but not paid by the umpire. McKenna. Long kick up to right half forward. Reed gets it to Beasley. Actually hung on to, no. Off the ground, one behind, or out of bounds. Sneaked in. So let's check the score. 105 to 98. So that's a difference of 7 points.
Just
points to tie the match.
Just on 26 and a half minutes, the ball comes back into play. Oh, who's going to be paid that mark? It'll be Barry Round. 7 points the difference. In favour of the Swans now. Barry Round with that mark out there at halfback. Well, finally comes out there, and Neesham, who hasn't played a bad game this quarter either for the Swans.
He's played a good half, Lou, since coming on, and his second half has been an excellent performance.
Kick by Neesham is up there towards the half-forward line for the Swans. In front will be a free kick to McAllister, no doubt about that.
Torbett going crook, but he should be in front.
That's right, the kick falling short. Neesham once again on that wing position. Ready to drive them back into attack. Steadies, goes for a pass. Oh, nearly a mark to Odom. I think the umpire will pay that. That was a great mark to Odom, right on the boundary line. He'd be about 45 to 50 metres out from goal as we watch it there in replay.
It's as close as you can get to hitting the ground, but there's Louis Hampshire.
He reckons it wasn't a mark, but the umpire said differently. Pack fly. No one can hold the mark. Finally, a wild hand pass coming out there to Morwood. Try to kick it off the ground. What has he done with it? It's a goal! Well, that's sewn it up now. It's 13 points the difference in favour of the Swans. Well, he had to wait. 14-27, 111, the Swans to Footscray, 15-8, 98. Well, it looked as though he wasn't quite there to get it, Bob. It could have gone over the line, but it worked out okay for him.
Well, Bernie Evans getting the hand pass over, and we see now very close to the line, but the goal umpire right there between the two sticks, so he could certainly see it.
Ball knocked out again by Reed. Round it was. Finally cleared away by Burton out to the wide open spaces. David Rhys-Jones on his own. Oh, bounced the wrong way. Certainly not having a great day. He goes down. Got a nasty knock on the leg too. Let's hope he's not seriously injured. Finally out to Wackley. And it's on the boundary line now. Footscray still going after it pretty strong. Not in a very good way that time, David Rhys-Jones. He got it right on the leg. Ball out of bounds on that centre wing position. And we're approaching the 29-minute mark of this last quarter.
Siren due to go shortly. The Swans have the game sewn up. They'll keep their finals five chances alive. Torbett in front grabs the ball. No mark paid by the umpire. Bourne up at right half forward. Rhys-Jones still in the hands of the trainers. Got one in the ankle region, I think. Or on the shin. Painful at the best of times. Now out it comes, Burton, or Davidson I should say, to right half forward, or half forward. Mark take it down there for Footscray. Out it comes to Templeton. Templeton gets the ball from Rod McPherson to the forward pocket. Bounces just inside. It will be a boundary throw in about 8 metres from the behind post. And the Swans should be able to hang on to this lead with the time in the final term nearly at the 30-minute mark. Rhys-Jones going straight off the ground. And again, we'll see another boundary throw-in. 111 to 98, the scoreboard. Footscray have kicked 15 goals, the Swans 14, but the Swans leading in quite a handy margin. Round, palms it down well. Cruz can't get clear. Taps it out, looking for Carroll, who takes it. He's well tackled, but umpire Kevin Smith will effect a bounce. There's the final siren. It's a victory to the Swans, and a pretty happy crowd here at the SCG. Gallant effort by Footscray. They really did try hard all day and were just beaten by a superior team, I think, in the final few minutes. 14-27, 111 to 15-8, 98.
Well, a great performance to come back like that by the Swans, but we've got to give full marks to Footscray. They put up a tremendous performance. Berry coming off, looked a very good player all day, and he looks tired like they all do.
So too, Michael Egan there. I thought, were Footscray's two best players coming off the ground together. Bill Berry, a tireless player in the ruck, and Michael Egan in the back pocket. He gave wonderful support for the Swans. Paul Morwood's first half, absolutely magnificent. Not quite as effective in the second half, making a number of mistakes. But then when you consider the fact that the Swans kicked 7 goals, 17. Simon Beasley, who finished with 5 goals, 2. But 7 goals, 17 to 7 goals, 2. So 15 points of difference there.
And, Bob.
Well, you know, I thought that Bill Berry's performance today, Peter, and Paul Morwood's first half was absolutely magnificent. He was clearly the best player on the ground there. But for a player to really take on Barry Round and have the better of Round and around the ground, I think Bill Berry deserves the ACCI recorder for his performance today.
So we'll check the goal kickers or the major ones and the time left for us, which isn't too long. Beasley 5, Edmund 2, the main ones for Footscray. Rod McPherson also got 2 for the Swans. Oaten got 4 goals, 2 to Tony Morwood, 2 to Torbett and 2 to Paul Morwood. The final scores, repeating them for you, 14-27, 111 to the Swans. They kicked 4-8 in that term to 15-8, 98 from Footscray. That takes us out from the Sydney Cricket Ground. Peter Dandy on behalf of Lou Richards and Bob Skilton on behalf of Seven Sport. Good afternoon to you all.